We completed the 9th chapter of Panchadashi. Now we are going to enter into the 10th chapter titled Nataka Deepa Prakaranam. Very, very popular chapter. In this chapter, Vidyaranya used one unique example, that is a light that which illumines the theater, a dance theater. That light he takes as example to present that Vedanta topic. That's why it is known as Nataka Deepa Prakaranam. Nataka means a drama or a dance. Any theater that which has got light, Deepa means light, in which theater the dance program or drama program is going on is called Nataka Deepa. That is the topic, Prakaranam. That is the topic in this chapter. A very small chapter, but very, very important chapter in which Vidyaranya talks about Jivan Mukti. In 9th chapter, the topic was Krama Mukti, but in this chapter, the topic is Jivan Mukti. Now you can see that Wednesday class and Thursday class are going parallelly. How that 8th chapter of Uddhava Gita we were seeing, that is Krama Mukti topic, that Hamsa Gita. And previous chapter in Uddhava Gita, Krama Mukti chapter over, we have entered Jivan Mukti chapter. And Thursday class, Panchadashi class also, we have completed Krama Mukti topic and we are entering Jivan Mukti topic. Coincidence. Maybe you are all very fortunate. That's why Bhagavan is giving this much opportunity to go with the subject parallelly so that you can grasp more and more. That is the idea. Now, in this chapter, what are the topics Vidyaranya presenting? First topic is Srishti topic, the creation topic he brings here. Then second topic is about Jiva, Jiva Srishti. Then third topic is the samsara or the bondage of that Jiva who is born in this creation. Samsara or bondage. Then fourth and final topic is what are the remedies, how to come out of this samsara? That is vichara topic, inquiry topic, to come out of this samsara problem. So totally four topics within 20 shlokas, the smallest chapter, only 20 shlokas. Now let us look at that example. The light illumines the hall, the theater, it illumines the actors, dancers in that hall who are all acting, playing their role. The light is the illuminator of that program, but light is not the participant of that program. Light is the illuminator of that program, but not the participant of that program, or it is not even spectator of that program, even it is not watching the program, it is not associated with that program at all. So light just illumining the program without any association with the roles of that program. That means without undergoing any change, light just illumines the program. Any program, any drama or dance, there is a tripudi. Tripudi means pramada, pramanam, prameyam. Pramada, the subject, prameyam, the object, and pramanam, the instrument. Or we can put another tripudi, karta, karma, karanam. Karta means the subject, karma means the object, karanam means the instrument, tripudi. Tripudi number one, pramata, pramanam, prameyam. Or tripudi number two, karta, karma, karanam. This tripudi is there in that theater, but light is not involved with the tripudi. It is beyond, with those actors and actresses. No involvement at all, but all the way the light is illumining the those actors and dancers. Now this is the example. What is the point we have to note here? The light is not associated with anyone in the hall, number one. Light is just illuminator of that hall. Light is not the participant of that hall programs. Light is a changeless illuminator. Light, without undergoing any change, it is the illuminator. This is drishtanta. Now come to darshtanta. In the place of light, you have to take sakshi. Sakshi, the witnesser. Sakshi is the illuminator of this entire world theater. Sakshi, the witnesser, is the illuminator of this entire world theater. Sakshi is not a participant of this tripudi that happening in the world. Pramata, pramanam, prameyam. The knower, known, knowledge, tripudi is not connected to Sakshi, the illuminator, the witnesser. Sakshi even not spectator of that tripudi happening in the world. Karta, karma, karanam. That tripudi is not having any connection with Sakshi, or Sakshi is not connected with tripudi. Sakshi is Nirvikara Prakashakaha. Just as the light is changelessly illumining the theater, the Sakshi is also the witnesser, the Sakshi Chaitanya, is also changelessly illumining the world Triputi. Nirvikara Prakashakaha. Changeless illuminator. Nirvikara Prakashakaha. This Sakshi is identical with the Brahman. This Sakshi is identical with the Brahman. Now, this Brahman happens to be the Srishti Karanam. Sakshi is identical with Brahman. Brahman is Sakshi. This Brahman happens to be the Karanam for this entire universe. Karanam is of two types, Nimitta Karanam and Upadana Karanam. In the first verse, Vidyaranya introducing that Brahman is the Nimitta Karanam and Upadana Karanam. Nimitta Karanam means intelligent cause. Upadana Karanam means material cause. So Brahman happens to be the Nimitta Karanam and Upadana Karanam of this universe, like our spider web. Spider creates its web from its own saliva. Yathornanabhi srijate grinhateja. That spider creates its web. Spider alone is Nimitta Karanam, intelligent cause to create the web. Spider alone is the material cause to create that spider web. Material also it brings from its own body. Intelligence also its own intelligence. Like that, Brahman also Abhinna Nimitta Upadana Karanam. Abhinna means non-different. Brahman is non-different from the intelligent cause and material cause of this universe. That means Brahman is the intelligent cause and material cause. That is the meaning. Now the next point is, material cause is of two types. Parinami Upadana Karanam, Vivartha Upadana Karanam. Material cause is of two types. That we are going to see from the first verse onwards. Now, this Triputi, what we are talking, Pramata, Pramanam, Prameyam, Karta, Karma, Karanam. After Triputi formation only, the time space comes. Before Triputi, the triangular, triad, there is no Desha and no Kala. The subject sees something, the object, through eyes, the subject-object transaction happens. When, where? The moment Triputi comes, only the time space will come. Without Triputi, there is no time and space. Pramata, the knower. Prameyam is known. Knower is knowing, getting knowledge. Then what comes? Where? When? When this knower is knowing that known object? Where this knower is knowing that known object? So, Desha, where? Kala, when. When indicates Kala, where indicates Desha, space. So this whole thing what I am talking in the Narayaniyam first verse, Sandra Nandava Bodhatmaka Manupamidam, Desha Kala Avadhibhyam Nirmuktam, Nigama Shata Sahasrena Nirbhasyamanam. So this Sakshi Chaitanyam is beyond Triputi, Desha Kala is within Triputi. Since Sakshi is beyond Triputi, Sakshi is beyond Deshakala. Deshakala Avadhibhyam. Avadhi means limit, seema. Avadhibhyam, nirmuktam, free, beyond. So Narayaniyam, first verse to understand, you have to study 10 Upanishads. I am going to Narayaniyam class. For chanting, for Chitta Shuddhi, for getting Punya, wonderful. But to understanding even first shloka of Narayaniyam, you need 10 Upanishads background knowledge. Otherwise you cannot understand what is Nigama Shata Sahasrena Nirbhasya Manam, Desha Kala Avadibhyam Nirmuktam. It is not just one day or 2 days, 1 year you can understand that shloka. Clear? Now what you have to think? First Narayaniyam I have to study or Upanishads I have to study? Narayaniyam what you are studying for bhukti, mukti, chitta shuddhi, wonderful, okay, continue. But you want to understand each and every word, its depth. Every Shastra, every Purana, its purport, its depth, if you want to understand, you need basic knowledge of Upanishads. Without Upanishadic knowledge, either Purana, even Bhagavata, Uddhava Gita also, you cannot grasp Hamsa Gita without Upanishads or Bhagavad Gita. So this Prasthanatrayam is the base for all other Purana Itihasas. Now come to the point. Triputi is within Deshakala, or Deshakala is within Triputi. So Triputi and Deshakala go together. Sakshi Chaitanyam is the illuminator of Triputi. Sakshi Chaitanyam is the illuminator of the Triputi. Sakshi is the one who is giving existence to the Triputi, to Desha, to Kala. So about that Sakshi we are going to study. With this background, we will enter into the first shloka, then I will pick up thread that what is Parinami Karanam. First verse, page number 426, 10th chapter, Nataka Deepa Prakaranam, The Lamp of the Theatre, English translation. Paramatma Dvayananda, Purna Purvam Swamayaya, Swayameva Jagat Bhutva, Pravisham Jiva Rupatah. Second line, there is a correction. Jagat Bhutva, that who, you have to give a small curl down below the dva. Jagat Bhutva it is, that is not clear. Pravisha, sha also, shakara is also not clear. Pravishan Jiva Rupataha. Now, Vidyaranya is introducing the first topic in the first verse itself. Paramatma alone enters, created this universe as Nimitta Karanam and Parinam, Upadana Karanam, and he became the Jiva, Jiva Rupataha, Jagat Bhutva. He created the world, and after creating the world, the Jivas, he enters the Jiva form. How to understand this? Very, very involved verse, loaded verse. Let me try my best. You also try your best to understand. The known topic only, but it is very subtle. I said Brahman is Nimitta Karanam, Upadana Karanam. Nimitta Karanam means intelligent cause. Parinami Upadana Karanam. Upadana Karanam means Upa Adiyate Iti Upadanam. Upa means you take near to you, Adiyate, that thing to create, to produce an object, karyam, the product. The goldsmith takes the gold to produce the ornament. Potmakers takes the clay to produce the pot. Carpenter takes the wood to produce the furniture. Therefore, wood, gold, clay, all of them are called Upadana Karanam. Weaver takes the thread to produce the cloth. Material cause is that taken by the intelligent cause. Material cause is that which is taken by the intelligent cause to produce the product, karyam. With regard to Brahman, intelligent cause need not go for material cause outside, like goldsmith, carpenter, weaver, potmaker. Like that, he need not go outside for Upadana Karanam. Brahman happens to be the Upadana Karanam also. That you know. Now, the Upadana Karanam is of two types we want to study now. Upadanam number one is Parinami Upadana Karanam. A material cause that which undergoes a change while producing the product. It is called Parinami Upadana Karana. Parinami means undergoing a change. A Upadana Karanam, if it is a Parinami Upadana Karanam, Parinama means undergoing a change to produce a product. For example, milk and curds. Milk is a Parinami Upadana Karanam. It undergoes a change to become the curds. Curds is the product. Milk is the Upadana Karanam. Without undergoing a change, milk cannot produce the curds. So the definition of Parinami Upadana Karanam is Swasvarupa Parityagena Rupantara Apattihi Parinami Upadana Karanam. I will explain. Swasvarupa Parityagena, by dropping its own nature, the sweetness, milk, the whiteness, the sweetness, and the liquidity, it is swarupam of that milk. It drops parityagena. Rupantara curds, another form it takes. Rupantara apatti. It takes another form like curds, which is solid, which is sour, little yellowish. Original milk is yellowish, not packet milk. Original milk appears yellowish, solid, and little sour. But milk is liquid, white, and sweet. That means milk to become curds, it has sacrificed parityagena, swasvarupa parityagena, the liquidity, the sweetness, the whiteness, parityagena. Rupantara, another rupam, solid, sour, yellowish, rupantaram, apattihi. Then what is the corollary? Once the parinami upadana karanam, it gives up its features and takes another form, another color, taste, everything. This parinami upadana karanam, milk is no more available. Milk is no more available. If it is available, suppose, after producing curd also, milk is as it is available. Then what? You need not buy milk at all. All the time you make curds, milk is as it is. Milk is as it is. It is not possible. Milk is not available. So milk is not available after producing its product, curds. That is called parinami upadana karana. The next cause is, all these are not there in the shloka. All these are sampradaya teacher only gives, based on Upanishadic teaching. In one shloka, there are many Upanishads teachings are hidden. In footnote, you can see so many Brihadaranyaka, Chandogya, Shvetashvatara, so many are there. That's why I said this shloka is very involved shloka. Now let us come to the second type of upadana karanam. It is called vivartha upadana karanam. Second type of upadana karanam, material cause, is vivartha upadana karanam. What it means? A vivartha upadana karanam is that without undergoing any change, it produces a product. Without undergoing any change. Swasvarupa aparityagena. Without giving up its nature, its features, its form, without undergoing any change, it produces a product. Swasvarupa aparityagena rupantara apatti. It appears as a product. You know our example, good old example, rope snake. Rope is the vivartha upadana karanam of a snake that which is seemingly appearing. Rope is the vivartha upadana karanam. In semi-darkness, you see a snake upon the rope. The rope is as it is without undergoing any change. While you are seeing the snake, even though it is not there, seemingly it is there, it is appearing to you because of semi-darkness. The rope has not undergone any change. Swasvarupa aparityagena. But it is appearing as rupantara apattihi, snake. Snake apattihi. In the form of snake it appears. And this person is frightened, shouting, screaming also. That is called vivartha upadana karana. Only one example I have given. Let us see two more examples. For parinami upadana karanam, seed and tree. Seed undergoes a change to become the tree. Once the tree comes, seed is not available. Seed has destroyed itself completely and became the tree. It is another example, this one, for Parinami Upadana Karanam. Similarly, for Vivartha Upadana Karanam also, another example is waker and dreamer. Without undergoing any change, waker produce the dreamer dream world. Suppose waker undergoes a change totally to become dreamer dream world, next day morning, aale kaanum, waker is out. Thank God, waker is intact. Waker has not changed completely. Waker as it is, it is there. This is another example for Vivartha Upadana Karanam. We are all Vivartha Upadana Karanam every day. I, the waker, am Vivartha Upadana Karanam of my dream. What a great job I am doing. This is second example. Third example, so many examples are there, mirage water. The sand, upon that you see water. The shining water appears, but sand has not changed anything without changing its form. Shell silver, I hope enough. Okay. So these are all Vivartha Upadana Karanam examples. Now let us go further. What about gold, clay and wood? Gold is Vivartha Upadana Karanam of ornaments or Parinami Upadana Karanam of ornaments. Wood is Parinami Upadana Karanam of furniture or Vivartha Upadana Karanam of furniture. Or clay is Parinami Upadana Karanam of pot or Vivartha Upadana Karanam of pot. Mind-boggling subject. Either, both the ways you can take here. I have not given this point highlighted in any class, but the topic has come. In Brihadaranyaka we saw long, long ago, not here, in some other class. In Chandogya, Brihadaranyaka, they are discussing. Now let us give me the, some few points regarding this. Gold is Parinami Upadana Karanam also, and gold is Vivartha Upadana Karanam also. Clay also, wood also. These three examples we can take Parinami, Vivartha also. How? Gold, when it becomes an ornament, it is shaped as ornament. Really speaking, when it is appearing as ornament, a product, gold is available. Swasvarupa aparityagena. Gold drishtya, gold has not changed totally. Gold is intact, available or not. If it is not available, who will go to Thangamaligai? Gold goes away, one chain comes in, who will go to Thangamaligai? Thank God, gold is intact. Swasvarupa aparityagena rupantara apatti. Therefore, gold is Vivartha Upadana Karanam. From gold drishtya, without undergoing any, that means without changing its goldness. Goldness is maintained. It has not given up goldness when it is becoming ornament. Therefore, it is not giving up the goldness. Therefore, gold is Vivartha Upadana Karanam, gold drishtya. Then how is it Parinami Upadana Karanam? Changing material cause. From ornament shape drishtya, gold is Parinami Upadana Karanam. Ornament shape, chain is a shape given to that gold. Bangle is the shape given to the gold. So some shape, the form, drishtya, gold is a parinami upadana karana. Shape drishtya. Similarly, wood also. Wood can be vivartha upadana karanam also, and it can be parinami upadana karanam also. As the furniture comes, woodness is available. Now the desk is wood, the woodness has not gone. Without sacrificing its woodness, the wood is available. Even then, that even though that shape of the desk has come, woodness is available. Therefore, vivartha upadana karana. Wood drishtya, wood is vivartha upadana karana. From furniture drishtya, shape drishtya, desk shape drishtya, wood is parinami upadana karana. To become the shape of that desk, so it has to undergo some modification, change. You can call it as parinami also. You can take this pot also, best example in the desk also available, practical example, pot also. The clay is also vivartha upadana karanam, because clayness continues when the pot is, product is there also, clayness continues or not? Continues. That's why clay drishtya, clay can be called as vivartha upadana karanam. But shape drishtya, pot shape drishtya, clay is parinami upadana karanam. That pot maker, being danda, chakra, and make it rotating, and he turns the clay into pot. Shape drishtya, it is parinami upadana karanam. Clay drishtya, it is vivartha upadana karanam. This is extra information for all of you. You are advanced students. You are going to enter Naishkarmya Siddhi. Therefore, I have to bring a lot of heavy ideas. Are you happy now? These are the crux, pillars of Vedanta. If you understand this, upadana karanam, nimitta karanam, vivartha karanam, parinami karanam, all this, now Brahman happens to be Sakshi Chaitanyam is vivartha upadana karanam we have taken. But in Chandogya Upanishad, clay, wood, krishnayatanam, krishnayanam means the iron, all introduced as parinami upadana karanam, changing material cause, they are introduced. Anyhow, now let us come to the shloka. Paramatma advaya ananda purnaha. So paramatma means the supreme self. Paramatma, the supreme self, is of the nature of advaya, secondless, ananda swarupam, purnaha, infinite nature. What this Paramatma did, advaya ananda purnaha, what he did, Paramatma. Swamayaya swayameva jagat bhutva, swamayaya, with its own maya, swamayaya, swayameva, by itself, here Paramatma means Brahman, by its own maya power, Brahman has got the maya power, which is associated with Brahman only, which is not separate from Brahman. Swamayaya, swayameva, by itself, became the world, jagat bhutva, created that world, jagat bhut, became the world. This is srishti topic. Then pravishat jiva rupata, having created sukshma prapancha from sukshma prapancha all sukshma sharirams have come. From sthula prapancha all sthula sharirams have come. Having this, created this sukshma shariram, Paramatma entered jiva rupataha, chidabhasa rupena, enters chit, chidabhasa rupena appears. Chit Paramatma chidabhasa rupena, Abhasa rupena or Pratibimba Chaitanya rupena or reflected consciousness in the form of reflected consciousness enters the subtle body. Which subtle body is within gross body? Stula shariram, sukshma shariram. So Bhagavan Paramatma entered the sukshma shariram. Then the sukshma shariram, stula shariram put together became the chivaha. The moment Paramatma enters as it were. In the reflected medium mirror, do you enter? Do you enter to say, reflected face to form? Do you enter the mirror? In your presence, the form, reflected face appears. Similarly, Chit Paramatma is all pervading. Once that Sukshma Shariram comes, this Jivatma, this Chidabhasa reflects. And the Chidabhasa alone is called Jivaha. Who is Jiva? Jiva is none other than reflected consciousness. Reflection of whom? Original consciousness. So original consciousness reflecting in the mind medium, Sukshma Shariram. What about Karana Shariram? The Karana Shariram is potential, even in Pralaya also it is there in potential form, Anadi. Maya is also Anadi, Karana Shariram is also Anadi. Anadi Avidya Maya Anadi. Anadi Avidya is the Karana Shariram. Potentially there, at the time of creation, Sukshma Shariram comes and the time this Siddhabhasa appears. Called Jiva, Jiva Rupataha Pravishate, as though entry. This is called Anupravesha Shruti. Tasrishtva Tadeva Anupravishate Tadanupravishya Satyaccha Bhavat Niruktancha Niruktancha Nilayanamcha Nilayanamcha Taittiriya Upanishad. A footnote it is given. Taittiriya Upanishad, Brahmanandavalli, second mantra. Seventh mantra, Brahmanandavalli. Not only that, Chandogya Upanishad 6-1, 6th chapter, 2nd section, Sadvidya, also this is given, Chandogya Upanishad, and Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, 3rd chapter, 9th Brahmanam, 34th mantra, that Advaya Ananda Purnaha, all these words are from Upanishads. Anando Brahme Divya Janat, that Ananda is original Ananda, Bimba Ananda. Teye Shatam Manushya Gandharvana Mananda, Teye Shatam Deva Gandharvana Mananda, all are Pratibimba Ananda. Here the Ananda Advayam, Ananda means Bimbananda, original Ananda. In Taittiriya Upanishad it is said, Sa yaschayam purushe yascha sa vadityay sa ekaha. Sa ekaha, that is Advayananda, that is Bimbananda, that is original Ananda, Atmananda. Pratibimba Ananda is the reflection of original Ananda. தேர்ஃபோர் ஆனந்த ஸ்வரூபம் பூர்ணா 511 ஆஃப் பிருஹதாரண்யக உபநிஷத் 5th சாப்டர் 1st பிராமணம் 1st மந்திர பூர்ணமத பூர்ணமிதம். கிளாஸ் முடியல, அது பிருஹதாரண்யகம்ல 551ல பூர்ணமத பூர்ணமிதம் கம்ஸ். தட் பூர்ணா வேர்ட் இஸ் தேர் இன் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் லைன். வேர் ஃப்ரம் திஸ் வேர்ட் இஸ் டேக்கன்? வித்யாரண்ய பாரூஸ்வரம் பிருஹதாரண்யக. அப்புறம் ரிதாரண்யகா பூர்ணமத பூர்ணமிதம் தட் பிரம்மன் இஸ் பூர்ணா இன்ஃபினிட். ஸோ த மாயா இஸ் ஆல்சோ அனாதி, யூ ஆர் டெல்லிங் பிரம்மன் இஸ் ஆல்சோ அனாதி பிகினிங்லெஸ். அப்போ துவைத்தம் ப்ராப்ளம் கம்ஸ். மாயையா வேர்ட் இஸ் கட்ஸ் ஃபார் மாயையா. வேர் ஃப்ரம் திஸ் மாயா ஹேஸ் கம்? இஸ் இட் சங்கராச்சாரியாஸ் இன்வென்ஷன் டிஸ்கவரி? வித்யாரண்யா சேஸ் இட்ஸ் நாட் மை டிஸ்கவரி, மை இன்வென்ஷன். ஸ்வேதாஸ்வதர உபனிஷத் சேஸ் மாயாம் து பிரகிருதி நித்தி மாயினம் து மகேஸ்வரம். ஸோ த மாயா இஸ் த பவர் ஆஃப் பிரம்மன், இட் இஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் தேர் வித் பிரம்மன். அப்போ மாயா இஸ் ஆல்சோ அனாதி, பிரம்மன் இஸ் ஆல்சோ அனாதி, துவைத்தம் ப்ராப்ளம் கம்ஸ் இன்? நோ நோ நோ, துவைத்தம் ப்ராப்ளம் வோன்ட் கம். அத்வயம் பிரம்மன் இஸ் எவர் அத்வயம், நான் ஜுவல் ஓன்லி. பிரம்மன் டசன்ட் ஹாவ் எட்ரிபியூட்ஸ் ஆல்சோ. இஃப் தெர் ஆர் எட்ரிபியூட்ஸ், பிரம்மன் வில் ஹாவ் வாட் இஸ் வில் பிகம் சகுணம். பிரம்மன் இஸ் நிர்குணம், தேர் ஃபோர் பார்ட்லெஸ், எட்ரிபியூட்லெஸ். பார்ட்ஸ் ஆர் தேர் சாவயவம், பிரம்மன் வில் பிகம் சாவயவம். வாட் இஸ் த நேச்சர் ஆஃப் பிரம்மன்? நிரவயவம். நிரவயவத்வாத் அவயவ ரஹிதத்வாத். பார்ட்ஸ் ஆர் நாட் தேர், அட்ரிபியூட்ஸ் ஆர் நாட் தேர், டுவாலிட்டி இஸ் ஆல்சோ செகண்ட் திங் ஆல்சோ நாட் தேர். அத்வய செகண்ட்னஸ். பட் வாட் அபவுட் திஸ் மாயா? தென் ஐ ஆஸ்க் யூ, வாட் அபவுட் யுவர் ஷேடோ? ஷேடோ இஸ் ஆல்சோ சேம் லைக் யூ. யுவர் ஷேடோ யூ கவுண்ட்? I am, you are giving one more eat, laddu for my shadow also. You are eating dinner, taking dinner, one laddu served. Your shadow is there next to you. Please give me one more laddu for my shadow. Do you ask? Do you count your shadow? Shadow is uncountable. How you account for your shadow? I don't count, unaccountable. And madri maya also cannot be counted, anirvachaniyam. It is adhyastam in Brahman. It is lower order of reality. It is mithya. It is uncountable. It can never under count at all. Maya is only vyavaharika satyam. Never count it as separate entity. It is lesser order of reality. Paramatma is higher order of reality. Ever ekameva dvitiyam, ever one alone. So kamayata, that is the chandogya, bahusyam praja eyete, idi taitriyam. Satapo tapyata satapas tattva idagam sarvam asrijata. அசிருஜதா இதகம் சர்வம் அசிருஜதா. பரமாத்மா கிரியேட்டட் எவ்ரி திங், ஹேவிங் கிரியேட்டட் என்டர்ஸ் த பாடி அண்ட் பிகேம் த ஜீவா. ஸோ பரமாத்மா அலோன் இஸ் த நிமித்த காரணம். வித் மாயா ஸ்டாண்ட் பாயிண்ட் பரிணாமி உபாதான காரணம், ஃப்ரம் பிரம்மன் ஸ்டாண்ட் பாயிண்ட் விவர்த்த உபாதான காரணம். Brahman, without undergoing any change, appears as, by lending existence, Brahman is ever intact. Whereas Maya, undergoing a change, it is called Parinami Upadana Karanam. In this world, Nama Rupas are undergoing a change. Over are those. Over the, enna pandrathu? You have to. Maya appearing in the form of Nama Rupa, changing Nama Rupa, Parinami Upadana Karana. The existence, the borrowed existence in this world is from Brahman. Without undergoing any change, Brahman lends the existence and consciousness also. So consciousness there is in desk also. Existence is there, consciousness is also there. Because existence alone is consciousness, consciousness alone is existence. But consciousness is not manifesting here. Suppose it manifests in every object. Idli asti. Idli is existing. Chapati asti, existing. Chapati is chitta also manifest, suppose. Sadeva chitta, chideva sattu. Chapati irukka. Chapati irukka, irindra podu. Enna chitta kode manifest aittanna, odi poidu. Because you are going to eat. Thank God. All objects, they are only manifesting sat. Whereas living beings, the jivas, especially we take human beings, because Panchadashi studies by only human beings. So the human beings, chit is manifesting more. I'm conscious of. Therefore, what? Who am I now? I am Paramatma only in the form of Jivatma. Sakshi Chaitanya Rupena Aham Triputi Illuminator. Body, that Chidabhasa Jiva, Chidabhasa Ahankara is the Pramata. Interacting with the Prameyam, world, with the Pramanams. Therefore, I, the Sakshi, am not even the subject, Pramata, or I am not the Karta. I am different from Triputi. Triputi Drashta Aham Asmi. Not Triputi Deshakala Bhinnaha Aham. So, changing one is Maya, changeless Sakshi Chaitanyam Aham, who is identical with Brahman. இப்போ பிரம்மன் எங்கே இருக்குன்னா தேடி தேடி கண்டி பிடிச்சி தேடுறவன் தான் பிரம்மன். தேட வேண்ட. ஓகே, ஐ ஆம் பிரம்மன், சீக்கர் டு சீயர். ஐ ஆம் நோ மோர் எ சீக்கர், ஐ ஆம் த சீயர். ஈவன் திஸ் திரஷ்டத்துவம், பிரமாத்திருத்வம், கர்த்திருத்வம் ஆல்சோ ஒன்லி டெம்பரரி. இட் இஸ் நாட் மை ரியல் நேச்சர். தே ஆர் ஆல் பிலாங் டு அகங்கார சிதாபாசம். I am the illuminator of Pramatrutvam, Kartrutvam, Bhoktrutvam also, without undergoing any change. What a status Shastra is giving for us. Your own status, Shastra is reminding. Why you have forgotten your Shakti? Like Hanuman has forgotten his Shakti. I cannot jump this Lanka river ocean. I cannot reach Lanka. I cannot cross this ocean. Then Jambavan has to come and remind Hanuman, show your Vishwarupam, you are not ordinary Vanaraha, you are great. Adi Madri, the Guru Jambavan has to come and tells to the Sishya, Vanaraha like Sishya, you are Brahman, Tattvamasi, Tattvamasi, Tattvamasi. Next verse, okay. This is the essence of this shloka. Number 2 verse.
Vishnuadyuttama
deheshu.
Vishnuadyuttama deheshu.
Pravishto devata bhavate.
Pravishto devata bhavate.
Matyadyadhama deheshu.
ஸ்திதோ பஜதி தேவதாம்.
விஷ்ணுவாதி உத்தம தேகேஷு பிரவிஷ்டஹ. நவ் வாட் ஆர் ஆல் டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஜீவாஸ் ஆர் தேர்? சம் ஜீவாஸ் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் தேர் புண்ணிய கர்மா தே ஆர் இன் celestial bodies or superior bodies. Uttama deheshu. Vishnu Adi. விஷ்ணு ஷரீரம், சிவ ஷரீரம் ஆர் பிரம்ம ஷரீரம், ஆல் தீஸ் ஷரீரம்ஸ் ஆர் உத்தம ஷரீரம்ஸ். இந்திரா, வருணா, அக்னி, வாயு ஆல் ஆர் உத்தம ஷரீரம்ஸ் பிரவிஷ்டா தேவதா அபவத். இந்திர தேவதா, சந்திர தேவதா, இந்திர தேவதா ஓ ஜீவா ஓன்லி சுப்பீரியர் ஜீவா பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் சுப்பீரியர் கர்மா, கேவல புண்ணிய கர்மேண தேவதா ஷரீரம் பிராப்னோதி. இந்திர தேவதா, வருண தேவதா, அக்னி தேவதா, வாயு தேவதா, தேர் ஆல் சுப்பீரியர் தேவதாஸ் வித் சுப்பீரியர் பாடிஸ். ஜீவாஸ் ஓன்லி. வாட் அபவுட் அஸ்? மர்த்தியாதம, மர்த்தியாதி அதம தேகேஷு. மர்த்தியா மீன்ஸ் ஹியூமன் பீயிங்ஸ், மோர்ட்டல் ஒன்ஸ். மர்த்தியம், மர்த்தியாதி ஆதி பதாது பேர்ட்ஸு, அனிமல்ஸு, அதர் லிவிங் பீயிங்ஸ் பாடிஸ். அதம தேகேஷு திஸ் பரமாத்மா என்டர்ஸ் த தேவ சரீரம் ஆல்சோ because of their punya, punya karma, that Paramatma reflects there in that bodies. Because of inferior karmas, inferior body, here also Paramatma reflects as Jiva, there as Devata. Now this Jiva is also Paramatma reflection only, that Devata is also Paramatma reflection only. What this Paramatma doing? தி ஜீவ ரூப பரமாத்மா வர்ஷிப்பிங் த தேவ ரூப பரமாத்மா. என்ன சுவாமினி இதெல்லாம் ஏதோ கதை மாதிரி இருக்கே. கதை இல்லை, நிஜம். ஓகே. ஸ்திதா அதம தேகேஷு ஸ்திதா, ஹவு திஸ் கர்மாஸ் இன்ஃபீரியர் கர்மாஸ், இஃப் யூ டூ யூ கெட் இன்ஃபீரியர் பாடி. தட்ஸ் வை வாட்டர் ப்ராப்ளம், பவர் கட் ப்ராப்ளம், so many other problems, adhidaivika tapani, adhibhautika tapani, adhyatmika tapani, with all these tapams, sthitaha, kim bhajati, devatam bhajati. So they worship the devatas, all the jivata, jivas, thinking they are jivas and worshipping for devas, and good rain, varuna devata, worshipping kariri yaga, for arkaha, varuna devatasi. சமுத்திர தேவதா தி வர்ஷிப், விரக்ஷ தேவதா வி வர்ஷிப், ஆல் தி ஜீவாஸ் ஆர் பஜதி மீன்ஸ் வர்ஷிப். ஸோ ஒன் பரமாத்மா அப்பியரிங் இன் தேவதா ஷரீரம் ஆல்சோ, சேம் பரமாத்மா ரிஃப்ளெக்டிங் இன் ஜீவ இண்டிவிஜுவல் அதம ஷரீரம்ஸ் ஆல்சோ. அதம ஷரீரம்ஸ் கால்டு ஜீவா, தே ஆர் கால்டு தேவதா. ஸோ த ரிஃப்ளெக்டட் கான்ஷியஸ்னெஸ்ஸஸ் ஓன்லி. How many reflected consciousnesses are there? As many bodies, so many reflected consciousnesses. Spelling is tagarar. Pronunciation is kashtam. Spelling is very kashtam. Okay. Now, how many reflections are there? So many bodies, so many reflections. So many devata shariams, so many devata reflections. So many human bodies, so many human body reflections. So jivas reflections, why so many varieties? Because of their karmas, different karmas, therefore there is a gradation between the karma, therefore there is a gradation between the body, therefore there is a gradation between punya, papa, sukha, dukha, everything. But in OC there is no gradation. Advaya purna ananda swarupe gradation nasti dehe. And the reflected consciousness alone, there is a gradation. Bhajati Devatam, third verse we will read. Aneka janma bhajanat,
Aneka janma bhajanat,
Svavicharam chikirshati,
Svavicharam chikirshati,
Vicharena vinashtaya, மாயாயாம் சிஷ்யதே ஸ்வயம். அநேக ஜென்ம பஜனாத், by many, many janmas, crores and crores of janmas later, bahunam janmanam ante jnanavan mam prapadyate. So after so many janmas, you have come to Panchadashi class. Who says? Shastra says, aneka janma bhajanat. Bhajanat means by worshipping the Lord in many, many janmas, the Paramatma, the Jiva has to worship the Lord in many janmas. Later, svavicharam chikirshati. After long time only, the Jiva starts enquiry Panchadashi class. Svavichara means self-enquiry. Enquiry into one's own nature. Chikirshati, kartum ichchati, chikirshati. Enquiry kartum ichchati. Like all of you, how you are sitting 1 hour, spellbound. Why? Not a love on me. Not love on Vidyaranya. You love yourself. Vidyaranya talking about you only. Of course, Guru is also talking about you only. Panchadashi book is also talking about you only. Upanishads are all talking about you only. Atmanastu kamaya sarvam priyam bhavati. Then what? Vicharena, by doing lot of enquiry, not sitting at home and doing enquiry. Tadvidhi pranipatena pariprashnena sevaya. Consistent, systematic study of Vedantic scriptures under a competent, alive teacher for a length of time. Vicharena. Then what happened? Mayayam vinashtayam. That Maya has got Vikshepa Shakti, Avarana Shakti. That Vikshepa Shakti continues, Avarana Shakti, veiling power of Maya. I am Paramatma only reflecting in this body. One day I recognize by Guru Vedanta Vakya Dwara. I recognize. Mayayam vinashtaya. Once Maya Avarana Shakti is destroyed, let Vikshepa Shakti continue, doesn't matter. Vyavaharika Prapancha continue, 12 o'clock you can go and take lunch. So Maya Vikshepa Shakti is the lunch. Let it continue. But Avarana Shakti has gone for good. Mayayam vinashtayam. Svayam Sishyate, that Paramatma alone remain. Jivatma recognize, I am none other than Paramatma. Your reflected face is enlightened face, suppose. Imagine, reflected face in the mirror, enlightened. Now, where am I existing without original face? No? Therefore, this reflected face is doing namaskara to the original face. Thank you, because of your blessing only I am here. This is called Mahavakya, Aikya Jnanam. I, the Jivatma, merging with Paramatma means not physically merging. Now, here itself, while sitting in the class, I am Paramatma only. I was thinking I am a householder, housewife, and so on, so on and on. No, no, no. That is my Vesham. I am Veshi Paramatma. Claim your Paramatma nature and put your Vesham and go. Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.